that you celebrate his Eucharistic presence among us. Let us bow our heads and humbly accept our own unworthiness and ask God and each other for forgiveness. I confess,
O Almighty God,
and to you are my brothers and sisters,
that I have previously sinned
in my thoughts and in my words,
in what I have done,
in what I have failed to do,
through my fault,
through my most grievous fault.
Therefore, I ask that the Saint of the Lord,
all the angels and saints,
and you, my brothers and sisters,
to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us. May He forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, by whose gift your faithful offer you right and praiseworthy service, grant, we pray, that we may hasten without stumbling to receive the things you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. It is a great joy to me in the Lord that at last you have shown some concern for me again. Though of course you were concerned before, and only at an opportunity. I am not talking about shortage of money. I have learned to manage on whatever I have. I know how to be poor, and I know how to be rich too. I have been through my initiation, and now I am ready for anything, anywhere. Full stomach or empty stomach, poverty or plenty. There is nothing I cannot master with the help of the one who gives me strength. All the same, it was good of you to share with me in my hardships. In the early days of the good news, as you people of Philippi, when I left Macedonia, no other church helped me with gifts of money. You were the only ones, and twice since my stay in Thessalonica, you have sent me what I needed. It is not your gift that I value. What is valuable to me is the interest that is mounting up in your account. Now for the time being, I have everything that I need and more. I am fully provided now that I have received from Epaphroditus the offering that you sent, a sweet fragrance, the sacrifice that God accepts and finds. In return, my God will fulfill all your needs in Christ Jesus as lavishly as only God can. This is the word of the Lord.
Amen. philosophy from Lahore. These days we have been reading the first reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians, and the gospel we are reading is about, it is taken from the gospel according to St. Luke. Now it's very interesting, and if you just look back over the last few days, Jesus is really teaching his disciples how to be his disciples. And he's making them aware of the cost of discipleship, what it means to be his follower. A few days earlier we read what Jesus says about taking up the cross, about giving up everything. He's training them, reminding them, to prepare them for the mission that's before them. And today, what do we hear Jesus say? If you cannot be trusted with money, that tainted thing, who will trust you with genuine riches? Just imagine. Use your imagination a little. There are no telephones, there are no mobiles, there's no television. If you have to communicate, you have to go out and talk to the people. As is written in the Gospels, Jesus went from place to place preaching. Just as today, who has come from Karachi? Which famous preacher do you know? Adem Hussain Rizvi, Maulana. He's probably going to preach hatred. Jalse Kwara, that's where all the traffic is disrupted. He's going from place to place, preaching about jihad and other things. Jesus, by informing his disciples, plainly tells them what to expect. What does it mean to be to follow Jesus? And that's what you have come to the seminary for. To be trained in how to be a disciple of Jesus. And the thing that today Jesus warns his disciples about is the use of money. Very strong words. He says that tainted thing. Tainted in English means the stupid dagalaga. Napak. Be careful how you use money. Because you are not going to become priests or religious because of any good salary. Your basic task is to do what Jesus did. He went out to the people, he healed the sick, he sat with the sinners and the poor, he told them that God loved them, and that if they had sinned, they could come back to invite them to salvation. He gave them good news. On the other side, you'll see the importance of that is the Pharisees. The Pharisees were the learned people. They were the teachers of the law of Moses. They studied the books at a time where hardly any people had went to school. They were the ones who knew how to read and write. How to read and write and how to interpret the law and how to preach. And they had made the law a burden for the people. You did not wash your hands before eating. According to the law, you are unclean. Take him out of the room. Remember what they did to Jesus? When Jesus healed a man whose hand was withered, he said, aha, according to the law, today is the Sabbath day. The law says you cannot do work on a Sabbath. You can't hear. And Jesus said, you hypocrites, I healed this man. And you don't see that God has done a great miracle by giving this man his arm back again. Alzam lagaye, sir. You hypocrites, if one of your animals falls into a ditch, won't you all go and pull it out? That will also work. And so it goes on. You can see the difference. What Jesus is trying to say. Don't go according to the standards of the world. I always like to give a little example. मैं आपने आपके सामने पेश करूंगा आपने इसे मुकम्मल करना है ईद का जवाब सबको आता है जी हाँ सी सीख है कौन सी बात है आपसे जी किसी बात है आपसे नहीं हाउ डू यू लर्न दीज थिंग्स एवरीबडी नोज आई ट्राइड इट मेनी टाइम्स बस्ते में जाके छोटे छोटे बच्चे भी देखे पत्थर से दो माशरे से सीखते वी लर्न मेनी अदर थिंग्स फ्रॉम आवर सोसाइटी एंड एज यूज द वर्ड द वर्ल्ड अराउंड अस टीचर्स अस मेनी थिंग्स वो सारे कर देते हैं कभी कभी और कोई गाते नहीं कुछ नहीं होता दीज आर द थिंग्स वी हियर हमारे कानों में यू एज सेमिनेरियंस हैव कम नाउ टू ओपन योर हार्ट्स गॉड्स एक्शन एवरी डे लिसनिंग टू द वर्ड ऑफ गॉड एवरी मॉर्निंग Celebrating the Eucharist, how much is it really going to change us? अगर हमारे दिल खुले ना हो, तो वैसे के वैसे जिसे हम formation के लिए foundation नहीं होता. If we harden our hearts, that's the word the Bible uses. तुम देखते हुए कि नहीं समझते, तुम्हारे कान हैं लेकिन तुम सुनते नहीं. We hear these words so many times. Become children, ठीक है. This is the word of the Lord, thanks be to God. It becomes a routine. Every day we must think, what is the Lord telling me today? So he's telling the Jesus is telling his disciples, don't put your trust in money, but learn to be trustworthy in whatever you do. Be content with what you have. Earlier he had said, if you do not give up your family and friends and take up the cross and follow me, you are not worthy of me. Jo haath par haath rakhkar piche dekhta hai, wo mere piche aane ka layak nahi. Jesus is training his disciples and that's what you are here for. To be trained in the word of God. To train in knowing what Jesus had trained his disciples to do. Now the same thing we see in the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. St. Paul went to one of the greatest, I would say, missionary in the history of the church. How he founded all those early, the first Christian communities, the first churches, Ephesus. Where is Ephesus? Kipsio ke naam par. What's your name in Ephesus? Turkey. It's in Turkey. And then Rome, the Romans. And then Corinthians, which is in Greece. And so on. Now he's writing to the Philippians. And Paul has been put in jail. But he's a big figure. Just dileri ke alawa, pura pura ikhmal hai. Daa mere saath hai. Jo main kar raha hoon, daa ka kaam kar. He's telling them, I am not talking about shortage of money, same point. I have learned to manage on whatever I have. I know how to be poor and I know how to be rich also. I have been through my initiation and now I am ready for anything, anywhere, full stomach or empty stomach. Poverty or plenty. There is nothing I cannot master with the help of the one who gives me strength. वो ही मुझे ताकत देता है. ऐसे हो ना हो, आना हो ना हो, उनका किस पॉल में चलता है. खाली हाथ कितने कलीसियाओं की बुनियाद रखी गई. Paul follows what Jesus And who was Paul? Was he just a simple man who was unpaired? No, he was a Pharisee. And who were the Pharisees, as I just said? They were the educated people. Nowadays you would say probably like a doctorate or something like that. They knew the law, they studied the law, but they made the law a burden. You keep defeating every small word in the law. And there are Jews today, even ultra-Orthodox Jews. On Sabbath, you cannot cook your food. Most Jews do that, not only the ultra-Orthodox. Orthodox and ultra-Orthodox, they will say, you cannot even press the button to put on your microwave to cook your food. Even to press the electric button, calm down, you cannot do it on the Sabbath. This is the key to the team. And they studied things so well, they knew exactly how to find fault with everybody. Just to show that I know the law. You have also come to study the holy books. And the Pharisees studied. Paul was a Pharisee. And he proudly says it when he's preaching to the Jewish people. You are a Pharisee, so am I. I know that you know the law, I also know the law. You can say it's just like Maulvi Nawabi is saying, "Main hafiz e Quran." Paul was like that, he was a cutting Jew. Sab wo badal jata hai. Yesu se milne se. Afterwards, changes completely. The one who was going to destroy the Christians, the early Christians, afterwards became not a destroyer but a great builder. How he built those early Christian communities. He became a pillar of the young church. So that's what you have come here. As Saul changed into Paul, all of us have to go through this transformation. Not only to gain knowledge. Without knowledge of the scriptures, without knowledge of the other learnings, history and science and philosophy, you will not be accepted in the modern world. But learning alone is not enough. It's what we are. It's what we are. Well, there's a story of a man who was a hakim. He was a very good man. And one day he made something in Jadi Bhuti or Dera Malam Yuke. He put it in a bottle and he said, now with this, whoever uses this, it's a head on it. And whoever is using his hair, if he uses it, he can grow his hair again. And he said, I am doing it for the good of the people. I bought money, I was selling very cheap. 5 rupees a bottle. And he was trying to sell his hair on it. So that those of Panja or Rithi Mereja say, Taki unke baad mein kaale ho jaye aur zyada ho jaye. But after a while, he met a friend of his, and this Dr. Saab was very disappointed and very sad. Dr. Saab, kya hua? Aapne achhi cheez banayi hai, aur logon ko takreeban muft mein de rahe. Why are you so disappointed? He says, nobody is buying my hair tonic. I don't know why. And his friend says, Dr. Saab, you don't know why. Tum to khud karte ho. So remember that you are beginning a new academic year. We have to learn and we have to study. Paul was a learned man and he could discuss with the Jews, he could discuss with the Greeks when he went to Corinth and the other great cities of Greece. The Greeks were great philosophers, they were great mathematicians, they were great scientists, and he was able to discuss with them and preach on their level. When he met the Jews, he was able to talk to the Jews. You know the law? I also know the law. You know what is written in the scriptures about the Messiah? I also know. And that's where the Jews would get angry and they tried to kill him. In the end, this was Shri Kiya. Because he was always one step ahead. Knowledge is important, but with it is our own life. What is Jesus telling us? Don't look for worldly things. Dunya kya kehti? Deen ka jawab hai kaise do? Dunya bahut kuch kehti hai. Yesu kehti hai. Allah but Pakistani Cabinet. This is what we get. It's not from the school. It's my life. How be? Otherwise, I would be like this good doctor, sir. वो भी कुछ कंपनी दे रहा है कि देखो करके जाहिर किया है लेकिन बेचारा को नहीं है. This is what we will be. So please, my dear seminarians, use this time to understand yourself, to deepen your commitment to Christ, because all of us in the end so committed. He says, I fought the fight, I have run the race, now I am ready to receive the prize of eternal life. He was martyred, he was put in prison so many times. Nothing stopped him. So you are here on a journey. Journey to discover knowledge, and also to make yourself a Christian, make yourself a disciple deep down, a disciple of Christ. Know what you have given up and don't seek the things that you don't really need to proclaim the good news. For this, my dear brothers and sisters, especially my dear seminarians, we have come today. Begin the new academic year by listening to the word of God, by celebrating the Eucharist, the presence of Christ among us, and asking for God's blessing. Let us then, very humbly, knowing none of us is worthy of all, we have to continuously work on ourselves to be true to the yes we have said. Christ calls us. May He bless you, may He guide you, and fill you with the Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that a people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity, made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit, might, to the praise of your manifold wisdom, be manifest as the Church. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen. The kingdom and power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us greet each other with a sign of peace.
NCIT choir to grace our stage with an opening hymn.
Traditional way. So I would like to invite our chief guest,
Dr. Trevor Rodriguez, director of the NDRE, to come on the stage, and I also invite Brother Prakash Bryan to come and garland our chief guest. I would also humbly request His Eminence Cardinal George Booth, the Chairman of Board of Governors of the NCIT, to please come on the stage. And I also invite Brother Vishal OFM to garland His Eminence.
I invite our chief guest, Dr. Sharon Rodriguez, Director of ND, and announce the new academic session of the academic year 2020-21. Please come on the stage.
I hereby announce opening of the session 2020-21.
Thank you, sir. Now, I would like to invite Reverend Father Shehbaz Nazir, the Deputy Dean of National Catholic Institute of Theology, to come and present his academic report.
Your Eminence Cardinal Joseph Booth, Chairman of the Board of Governors NCIT, Chief Guest Dr. Sharon Rodriguez, Director of NDIE, respected deputies and superiors of the affiliated houses, dear academic staff members, students and distinguished guests, welcome to all of you at the opening of the academic year 2020-2021. Good evening to all of you. Before saying anything, I would like to thank God for bringing us safely to this point and for guiding us so far to carry on our mission of love and service in Pakistan. We began this academic year on 6th of November 2020. In the morning, at 9 o'clock, we had an orientation program with staff and students in which Reverend Father Akhtar Nabeel Hopi shared about the effects of the COVID-19 and challenges for the church and our response towards these challenges. After that, the students were encouraged to elect their representatives who are competent and able to help coordinate and contribute in different activities at NCIT. The fruit of their elections, Brother Prakash Bryan of Theology 4 is elected the President of Student Body, and his collaborators, Brother Irfan Price Topi, Brother Adil Koemai, and Brother Nabeel Arif Koemai. Then the academic dean introduced NCIT's mission, its philosophy of education, and explained other rules to the students. In the evening, an entry test was held for Theology 1. Along with this information, I would like to restate that NCIT is a national institute where students come from different formation courses, namely Christ the King Major Seminary, Capuchin Friars, Dominican House, Franciscan Friar, Oblates of Mary Immaculate, and Nativity. And it offers two categories of studies, DTS, Diploma of Theological Studies, which is a 4-year diploma course offered at CTS premises mainly to candidates for the priesthood. But lay people are also welcome to join. And CTS, Certificate of Theological Studies, is a 3-year program especially for lay faithful who want to deepen their Christian faith and are willing to play an active role in the church and society. This course is offered at St. Joseph's College, Karachi on every Wednesday and Friday. During this year, the following courses will be offered. Introduction to Sacred Scripture, Principle and Practice of Spiritual Direction, Introduction to Theology, Theology and Liturgy of the Eucharist, Social Doctrine of the Church, Liturgical Mysteries in the Church, Church History, Origin to the Present, Pentateuch, Comparative Religions and Interreligious Dialogue. I desire that our parish priests, sisters, principals and head of various institutes encourage their people to take advantage of this offer. Students stand. We are going to begin this academic year with 103 students, DTS students 85 and CTS 18 students. The grouping is as follows. Theology 1, DTS students, Theology 1, 25 students, Theology 2, 19 students, Theology 3, 14 students, Theology 4, final year, 27 students, diploma. Congregation wise, Canon Regular of Jesus the Lord, 1 student, Captains, 5 students, Dominicans, 9 students, Franciscans, 4 students, Oblates, 15 students. Students from CTS 47 and 4 students from New Catechumens, altogether diocesan 51 students. Diocese wise, they are as follows. Archdiocese of Karachi, 14 students. Archdiocese of Lahore, 12 students. Islamabad Rawalpindi Diocese, 8 students. Faisalabad Diocese, 5 students. Multan Diocese, 6 students. Hyderabad Diocese, 2 students. I wholeheartedly welcome the students of Theology 1 who have joined NCIT for the first time. We welcome them with claps. I encourage them to work hard and to learn for life. Likewise, I also extend my warm welcome to the students of Theology 2 and special welcome to Theology 3 who were on their 6 months pastoral semester in various parishes and communities in Pakistan. I firmly believe they have learned many practical things during their pastoral exposure which have made them more mature and committed for this mission. Finally, I welcome the most senior students of our institute who are in their final year. They must bear in mind that they have to work hard to fulfill all the requirements of NCIT, namely jurisdictions exam, assignments, and other routine exams. A diploma will be given to them only if they successfully complete all these tasks. Likewise, I extend my welcome to our CTS students who will also continue their learning at NCIT. I recommend that they must be regular and inform other students about it. Thanks to academic staff members. NCIT is grateful to God who has blessed this institute with dedicated academic staff. I welcome them all in the new academic year. And I also thank them for their cooperation, concern and sincere heart. May God bless you all and may this institute improve each day according to the needs of the church in Pakistan. Thanks to our chief guest, Dr. Sharon Broderick, Director of NDIT. We serve your presence is a source of encouragement for all of us. God bless you. Special thanks to His Eminence Cardinal Joseph Hoops, Chairman of the Board of Governors and CIT. His Eminence, from the time you were a part of NCIT administrative body, you have given a special care and concern to its growth and well-being. Your personal interest with your knowledge, wisdom, and academic and practical expertise to NCIT's upliftment is highly appreciated. You always gave us directions, vision, and advice. We cannot measure your contribution to NCIT. The value you have added with your inspirational guidance is actually priceless. Though you have completed your term as the Chairman of Board of Governors, we will always remember you and depend on your contribution for the formation of future Greece through this institute. May God continue to use your abilities for the service of the diocese and the local church in Pakistan. Thank you very much and God bless you.
Engagement. When I'm thinking of engagement, I'm looking at
sustained energy. The energy, the hard work that was referred to earlier, that students and faculty bring to the program, bring to the course. So this needs an element of continuity. So engagement, staying on task, meeting the requirement of the assignments, day in, day out, that goes a long way. However, all this may not be fruitful unless and until we are somehow empowered, E number 4, empowered to grasp the concepts, empowered to own things, empowered to believe in it ourselves, and convince others of the importance of it. So empowerment is another very strong factor. Something that both faculty and students can take away with them in this journey of learning. Number 6, empathy. The dual nature of understanding. And so faculty sometimes wonder, why aren't students meeting the deadline? Why are they not doing the work up to a certain level, meeting the criteria? I shared the criteria with them. Okay? But empathy is trying to put ourselves in the other person's shoes. What is going on? Maybe the student is not interested enough. How can I as a faculty motivate them? Same with the students. The faculty is not maybe engaging or using a variety of techniques. So it's very important to have this sense of empathy, to understand each other and situations from a different point of view. Other person's point. The next one is enlightenment. I think in education it's about creating awareness, and in theology it's the spiritual enlightenment, being aware of the importance of God, the divine, certain values. So that enlightenment is an awakening and it's very powerful. So that is one of the another ease which I have on my list, that number 7. Number 8 is the environment. What is going on around us? If something is not being done in an appropriate manner, do we just let it go by? Or do we take a stand? But sometimes taking a stand is a very difficult prospect. It's not easy. Sometimes a person's life may be at stake. So that's important. The environment, being sensitized to the environment, aware of what is happening, and sometimes challenging things, which we feel are not acceptable. Not simply going in with the rest, going in with the flow. So being aware and trying to make a positive contribution to that. Number 9 is the eternal nature of learning. So it is not a one-off thing, it is not confined to the course. It is ongoing, it is everlasting. It is a joint venture between faculty and students, a journey of exploration and enjoyment. So being open-minded to new concepts, to new ideas, to things which might at times discomfort us and certainly question our existing ideas and background and knowledge and prior experiences, I think that is important. And finally, E number 10 that I picked up when the notion of extend, the word extend is mentioned. So for me, no course is complete unless and until we can extend that learning that has been assimilated by us into other contexts, into the wider community. So that's E number 10 for me. Extend your learning and take it beyond classroom situation, beyond this immediate environment, to the wider society so that we can empower others, enlighten others, and above all create a safer, more engaging community of practitioners. And as far as the journey that was shared at the beginning about the introduction of the chief guest, I would like that to be our journey. So So I would like that to be 5 years from now, 10 years from now, the student's pathway to success. Wish you all the best on your journey and excitement, both the faculty and students, and may God bless you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir, for your precious thoughts and the beautiful message and the key points you have shared with us in our life. And once again, we would like to call upon you on this stage, and I would also like to invite Shivas and see if they can be. Please come and present a copy of the Kuachi test.
The pandemic disease, COVID-19, affected the every sphere of life. I invite NCIT students to come and present a tableau to show the role of youth in this difficult time.
To share his precious thoughts and express
for the field studies, the director, academic staff, and dear students. But I'm very happy to be here again. And I'm very happy that this event is taking place. Because a few months ago, the situation looked very bleak. Even the government was not sure where the school should be reopened. And we didn't know exactly where we were going, because COVID-19 is a new virus. And doctors and scientists are still trying to know more about it and how it's going to behave. So that was really a very bleak time. So I would just like to commend all the staff members for having really risen to the occasion, come together, and then started by giving assignments to the students. And I am told that all the students responded very well. And the semester, the first semester, which was cut short somewhere in March, I think, wasn't it? In March, that our seminaries had to be closed, all seminaries, and everybody went home. And then you put yourself together and came back in October, was it? 15th of September, you came back, and they raced through the rest of the semester, which had been cut short, and managed to conclude on the 3rd of this month, November. And only with a few break of a few days, they closed the last semester, sorry, not this, was it last year, academic year? Yes, was closed, and they had a graduation ceremony, and now just 4 days later, on the 7th, they've started the new academic year, which was really, I must commend you for that. It was your hard work and dedication that made this possible. And it's so nice to see, that we have the new students have come in, a good group, 25. So you are about nearly 25% or 23% of the total student strength. So that's a wonderful start. And with Dr. Sherman giving us some very practical points. Remember the letters E, 10 times. Yeah, wonderful. So may God bless you all. Bless all our efforts. And I might as well tell you that my second term as president of the MCIT is over. And yesterday we concluded our bishops' conference. So the board of governors has two representatives from the bishops' conference and two representatives from the major religious superiors. So the two new bishops who will serve on the board are Bishop Benny Travis of Multan and Bishop Indriyas Ramath of the Diocese of Faisalabad. So they will serve on the new governing board as soon as the dean calls the meeting. And for the major superiors, Father Khan Polus, who has been teaching here before, all three of them are not strangers. They all had already close links with the MCIT. So there's also a good sign, and we look forward to move ahead. So once again, congratulations. Oh, Father, you should have, I think we have a few new staff members, academic staff. Are you going to invite them or introduce them to them? Will you do that?
Yes.
Okay, then that's okay, because I see one of them sitting before me. So that would be nice so that we know who the new staff members who have joined the staff. So thank you very much. I wish you all the best. God bless you all.
Once again, I would like to please come on the stage. And I would like to call upon Father Shabasnasi, the deputy present to talk number.
It is here, Reverend Father Amar Bhatti with us. So he will be with us in this new semester, 2021. I would like to invite him on the stage. Father.
Now, I would like to invite new elected student body, Brother Lucas Bryan, to come and say words of thanks.
Your Eminence,
Your valued presence here among us is indeed a cause of immense joy and exhilaration, and I take hold of the blessed moment that I am privileged to say few things before you. Honorable Chief Guest, Dr. Sherwin Rodrigues, Director of NDIE, Advised Academic Dean of Studies, Reverend Father Shabbat Musi, respected teaching staff, and my dear brothers. The core of my heart echoes with gratitude, lending a bunch of thanks to my classmates who have elected me as the president of Student of Poly. I believe that the birds of a feather flock together, and here lies my assurance that before you, with your generous collaboration, I will endeavor with a charitable heart to accomplish the task you have entrusted me, enveloped in this responsibility. It is equally justifying bringing into your presence that we have blessed and joyful assemblies thrice during this week, which includes the graduation ceremony of the graduates, the annual academic orientation, and the inauguration of the 64th academic year 2020 and 2021 in the NCIT. I sincerely thanks all the efforts my brother have made for the success of these programs, especially those who have hosted the programs, chapel decorators and liturgians, hall preparing and rearranging committee, sound and lightning operators, food serving and providing committee, and mainly the supporting staff, Mr. Albert, Mr. Bokas, Mr. Nasir, and other units. I desire, with the support of each other, we will continue enriching ourselves with the treasures of God knowledge. Thank you so much. Now, once again, I would like to invite our chief guest, Dr. Sherwin Rodrigues, Director of NDIE, please come on the stage and close the inaugural section of the academic year 2020-2021.
I hereby close the academic session 2020-2021. Thank you, sir.
On behalf of NCIT, I thank you all for making time in your busy schedules to join us here this evening. It's been our pleasure to host this event. I wish you all a pleasant evening. Dinner is ready. His Eminence, our chief guest, and all the staff members will proceed towards the academic staff room for dinner, and students go to the NCIT lobby.